I mean, I might just book rehearsal space and then see if anybody wants to use it, and then
yeah,
I'll be there.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, I'm gonna just show up in full drag.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna have an outfit change in my bag for like half.
So and smart.
Not even change my wig, because I'm like, I know what that back room looks like.
I don't
like.
Even know if yeah. I got tickets for tomorrow.
I'm Carla Marks. I'm a drag queen and burlesque performer and comedian for Cabaret Calgary. So I'm also a producer as well. So I produce events and perform and host, kind of do a little bit of everything. Cabaret Calgary is an events company. That's really what we focus on doing is cabaret arts, which is really fun because it's interdisciplinary by nature. Our bread and butter is definitely burlesque, but we also do a lot of drag, comedy, live music.
And be like, yeah, no, none of us have vaccines, but you're a loser.
My name is Ivy LaFleur. I'm a part of the Cabaret Calgary board, and I help produce shows, a frequent entertainer, and I work with a lot of musicians and bringing that element to Cabaret Calgary. You can tell when something's a Cabaret Calgary show because it's professional, it's well-rounded, it's dynamic in entertainment.
Calgary brought burlesque back to Twisted in a big way, and we run a monthly show there, and it's been really interesting to see how more younger queer people are starting to say, oh, like drag is really fun, but there's this other thing that I can do too, and that seems kind of cool, and it seems to kind of celebrate my sexuality, and burlesque is like, yeah, we always have been.
Hi, my name is Bellissima, and this is Molly, if you see her. I am a burlesque performer and producer with Cabaret Calgary, as well as an instructor. Because Cabaret Calgary has, and Carla has brought burlesque into our drag community here, there's so many queer performers or like people who want to perform that are now seeing burlesque as this way of being a part of a performance community that isn't necessarily drag. So there's like another way for people to, especially queer people, to express themselves and how they want to like feel good in their bodies.
Prairie Cherry is a live wire. You know, she's very in the moment. She's very charismatic. And she's one of those performers that can do sex with a smile. There's lots of people who do like smolder and intense looks or a sneer or things like that. And Prairie's one of those people that just has a giant smile on her face all the time.
They've taught me is just so far is just to let go and have fun and just remember that the only person that knows you're messing up is you while you're on the stage. And I think just giving that freedom to just be and to express myself has just been so opening for me. As I mentioned, when I started burlesque, it actually was, you know, a few years ago when I first went to burlesquerize. And right after that, I actually went through cancer. I had breast cancer. And so while I was going through cancer, I was still going to classes, and it was keeping me positive and motivated, and just to move my body. And then, because there was just so much turmoil that was going on, so it helped me to feel in control, but also to feel still who I am, because I lost all my hair, I lost my eyebrows, I lost everything. So this is like 2 years of regrowth, and you know, it's just, I feel like this is becoming, it's allowing me to become who I am, who has been hidden away for so long.
We want people to realize entertainers are valuable. So it's really important that we collaborate with venues and that we are making sure we're paying our performers what they are worth being paid. So it's about creating jobs for entertainers. And I think that's a really important goal of ours that we've been fulfilling and continue to work towards. And we want to be stepping stones to help them get to those opportunities. We want to help make that possible and know that not only are they wanted, but they're needed in this community.
Cabaret Calgary created Cab Lab, or the Cabaret Laboratory, which is an opportunity for us to teach the community and offer a way to share all that we've learned over time with everyone else. And we are also able to, through the classes, be able to offer a racialized option for performers who are wanting to get, you know, into burlesque but don't know where to start. I think because of that offering, we're able to have more or have like newer performers join us who are a part of that racialized community, which has been a hard thing, I think, in burlesque for some time. I know when I started 15 years ago, I was the only racialized person. So it was a very, you know, lonely experience. And there was a lot of things about burlesque that I didn't get to share with others. And now we have our own, you know, little like micro community within this larger community. So East and West, as a performer, I've known him before, and we met through like pride gatherings. So he kind of just expressed this interest in doing burlesque, and the timing of us creating Cab Lab was just really perfect. And so he was taking all the classes, he was coming to the BIPOC drop-in. He's kind of been just really engaged and a part of the community for the last few months. And it's been a really lovely thing to see him grow in this art form.
Being with Cabaret Calgary and having Bitch Sassity as a mentor, since they're all queer folks and either are trans or have trans folks in their lives, it's this really safe and warm space. Me being a masculine performer, and burlesque majority being more feminine art form, they've been really mindful of kind of finding more masculine movements or making either the classes they teach more comfortable if your gender is more masculine, like mine is. So Cabaret Calgary and the community at large is very, I mean, they experience that feeling as well, but they're very eager to push you through that fear and have you know they just want to see you up there. So that stage fright is a lot easier to work through, and you can go up there knowing people want to see you there.
It's kind of a big wide world when you crack in with Cabaret Calgary and you realize how many shows we run, and that we always really do our best to try to create as diverse lineups as we can, and maybe they're not quite ready for this show yet or something like that, but they could be a good fit here and they can develop skills here. And I think that that's one of the things that Cabaret Calgary really does well, is we try to see each performer and their unique talents and what they do offer, and then find a good fit so they're gonna have a good experience, instead of just, yeah, sure, just throw them into the deep end and do something. It's like, well, what's gonna be successful for both Cabaret Calgary and that performer, so they're gonna have a good experience and then wanna grow from that. So I met Lola at events. She was this stunning, striking human that I was like, well, this person understands fashion. She always looked so amazing. Eventually I was like, so you're gonna do drag? And she was like, what? And I was like, you need to do drag. You're already like doing drag. Let's just get you to do drag now on stage. And she's like, okay. And so we started exploring makeup, because she's a very talented makeup artist already. So I just, for her, with this daughter, she has looks, she has an aesthetic, she knows what she wants to do. I taught her some drag arts of how to do that in a drag way with makeup and stuff. And for her, it's mostly supporting her and saying, take up space, go as big as you can, get on that stage and just soak up the attention, and you can be so extra and vibrant. And she's taking her first steps now, and it's so cool to watch.
Yeah, Lola Jet is just a punk rock princess who doesn't give a fuck. So, I don't know, can I swear? I don't know.
Yeah.
just like being like strong and like powerful and doing something that makes me really like feel like I'm doing something that like my younger self would be really proud of. And yeah, I don't know. I feel like I'm such a procrastinator, and I'm, you know, like just mental health. You know, you always are your own worst enemy. And so I'm just really thankful to have this community and have the support that I do to like just let me be an artist.
As a performer, being surrounded by people who are constantly inspiring you is just kind of like constantly having cheerleaders in your corner, you know, so it makes you excited to continue pushing yourself to work hard. Yeah, when people are investing in you, you want to invest back in them. The second you get on stage, nothing else matters, you know, like it's really easy just to like feel at ease. Like I completely understand why I'm there the moment I step on stage, or the moment I like even like hug like someone from the community, you know, like it just feels so safe, and I'm constantly reminded why I show up in this world.
I can be as tired as I currently am after 3 shows yesterday. And tomorrow morning I'm gonna walk onto that stage for a brunch, and I'll hear that first cheer, and I'm not thinking about how tired I am or how my feet feel. I'll have so much energy in my step, and I'll be so excited to get back out there. And honestly, it's the roar of the crowd, the friends that you make in the community, those people who are like, wow, this was the sparkly, shiny thing that got me through my week, because I knew I was gonna come and have fun here, and I did. And, you know, watching people come into this community and find a place that they feel like they belong, that's what keeps me going. It's all about the community, it's all about the people.
Work on 3, 1, 2, 3, work! All right. We really appreciate this huge show of support. We're gonna have more events coming to Dickens, so come and check it out. It's so great to be back here. Thank you so much for supporting us tonight. Take care of each other. Don't worry, don't read Twitter just stay on Twitter for like 48 hours. Love yourself. Okay, we'll see you later, babies. Get home, get me safe. We love you. Good night!